The main opposition UNP threatened to take to the streets against a government decision to hold back a state sector wage hike till 2011.
They made a promise. Their promise was Janadhipati Varne Evrunada Pasua, Didas Pansie, Vetu Pedikiri Maklabadino. And they have increased the prices of all items. Prices have gone up, inflation has gone up, cost of living has gone up. It is their duty to give it. Right? So there is no talk about next year, they should give it this year. We are taking that stand.
So which kind of steps you are going to take?
We will be talking to trade unions, we will be talking to the government servants, different unions, and as an opposition, with the joint opposition, we will decide on taking certain action to start street protests. We start protests against this until the salary increment is given.
Critics say salaries put the greatest pressure on state cash flows and triggers money printing lending to inflation when enough taxes cannot be raised from the people. The UNP charged that the 2010 budget was tailored to appease the International Monetary Fund, which earlier held back the disbursement of the third tranche in a two-year program in February 2010 after lavish government spending pushed the budget deficit to 9.8% of gross domestic product in 2009 from a planned 7%.
Mind the chintana idiri dakma kriyaatmaka karanna one ayavayak meka namuth me ayavaya kohomada idiripat kare මේක හරියට අර තටම්බලා 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 අන්තිමේට එළියට ආවේ මොකද්ද පොඩි මීපැටියෙක් ඒකත් එහේ මීපැටියා මේඩ් ඉන් USA මීපැටියෙක් කියන්නේ කෙලින්ම IMF මීපැටියෙක් තමයි තටම්බලා තටම්බලා එළියට ආවේ
The IMF said they are pleased with the government's 2010 budget presented to Parliament on Tuesday, with the deficit reduced to 8% of gross domestic product from 9.9% last year.
The budget deficit reduction is being done in a very sensible way. It's not being done through unrealistic revenue projections. Indeed, the government has a relatively conservative projection of 14.75% of GDP in revenues this year. It's not being done through an artificial curtailment in capital spending. There are many countries that I've worked on in the past, which have achieved fiscal adjustment through freezing the capital budget. And that's clearly not what this government has in mind. They have always emphasized the importance of infrastructure development, and we think that's appropriate. Rather, this compression in the deficit is being achieved through a reduction in recurrent spending. And I should emphasize a reduction relative to growing GDP. Many categories of spending are being kept constant in nominal terms, but against a growing GDP, that implies some savings. So the deficit in terms of GDP is coming down. That's the strategy for this year.
Today we bring you some views expressed by government and opposition parliament members on the budget proposals presented to parliament yesterday.
I think the budget presented today was an absolutely and totally incoherent budget that was formulated based on a lack of knowledge on basic economic principles. The development sector of our country has been absolutely and totally neglected.
Well, that's the usual thing in Sri Lanka, because when a budget is presented, the people who present it, the government says it's the best budget. The opposition says that's the worst budget. So it is no difference the comments that you get. But in fact, you cannot expect a miraculous change within a period of 6 months, and it's more of a interim arrangement. A real budget would come, I'm sure, by 2011, by November.
IMF people issue this budget. So this is not government budget. I am waiting to see government budget.
By December, I think we would be able to have some sort of relief package to the working people and other general public as well.
It's nothing but an IMF dictate. There was a saying, those days when we used to go to school, first to Bata, then to school. This time it's first to IMF, then to Parliament. Essentially, they went with their budget to the IMF board yesterday and got them to approve the budget, and they presented it to the Parliament and to the people today.
This budget, I think, better than the last budget.
The budget is just an eyewash, and it is obviously a beautiful story.
Government ගෙවල් වලට යන මාර්ග තියෙනවා වහාම දේවල් තියෙන මාර්ග වෙන. ඒකවත් දැන් කරන්න පුළුවන් නේ. ආ අරගෙන මරම පොලේ කරා මේ ගෑපෑතුමා අලුත් අලුත් දේ දෙනවනේ හැමෝටම පුහුණු වීම.
මේක එහෙම් පිටින්ම ජාත්‍යන්තර මූල්‍ය අරමුදල විසින් ලබා දුන්න රුපියල් ඩොලර් මිලියන 400ට කප්පම් වශයෙන් මේ රටේ ජනතාවගේ සහනාධාර සහ ඔවුන්ට ලබා දෙන්න තියෙන සහන කප්පාදු කරන ලද අයවැයක් විදිහට තමයි මම දකින්නේ.
මෙය ඉදිරිපත් කිරීමට අලුතෙන්ම අමාත්‍යවරයා නියෝජ්‍ය අමාත්‍යවරයාට වැඩබලන අමාත්‍ය ධූරය දීලා ජනා මුදල් අමාත්‍යවරයා ලෙස ජනාධිපතිවරයා මේ මගහැර යාමින්ම පෙන්නුම් කරන්නේ ඔහුටත්ම පාර්ලිමේන්තුවට ඇවිල්ලා ඉදිරිපත් කරන්න බැරි තරමේ හාස්‍ය උපදවන ලේඛනය බවට මේ ලේඛනය පත් වී තිබෙනවා.
This is completely a IMF budget that has been given in disguise and the little benefit that could have been obtained by the people of this country have been eroded by the IMF intrusion into the Sri Lankan affairs.
IMF they are not in the business of preparing budgets. The problem is opposition is out of date. They have been so long out of power that they don't know what is happening in the modern world. This has nothing to do with IMF. We have prepared our own budget, and of course we at the same time today we got the news that IMF has agreed to give the fourth tranche of over $400 million. So that's very good. That will add to our foreign exchange reserves.
The Met Department predicts showers at times with fairly strong winds in the western, central and Sabaragamu provinces and in the Gaul and Mathur districts. The sea area of western and southern coast will be fairly rough and windy.
You can now follow Debrief on YouTube, Twitter and Facebook.